Hello everyone, how you going? And welcome back to another episode of Minecraft World with No Regen. Now obviously, as you can see, and as you would know if you've seen the last couple of episodes, you know, we are starting to certainly get enchanted out, you know. We've got the absolutely beastly pigs, we've got the sword, we've got the armor, as well as just all these animals, and even though I haven't ridden this guy in a while, just this ungodly jumping horse, look at this. But anyway, as you would know, we're obviously on our way to beat the Ender Dragon, so I don't know if I've got anything smelting. Yes, I do, here we go. So we've got level 27. Now I don't know if there's anything else that I really feel like enchanting, perhaps I could kind of combine that. I guess really the next step is going to be more along the lines of trying to get diamond armor, just to be that little bit more protection, you know. But really, obviously we know the main one is gold, you know. But even though we do have 10 golden apples, you go, oh, you know, that's so great. No, that we have, like, I don't know, I think I counted like last time, but I think I've lost hearts since then. I think I need something like 18 golden apples to be able to get back to full. I guess granted, I don't need to be back to full health or anything like that, but really just something about having a couple of hearts missing when I just know that I can't regen is just a little bit scary, you know. Those couple hearts might be the difference between life and death, and you know, once I die, there is no turning back from that. So obviously, whoa, I didn't even know you could get the local brewery achievement just from getting glass bottles out. That is really quite strange. I had no idea you could do that. But anyway, speaking of brewing, you know, obviously we know that we don't have any blaze powders. Really, I've barely even ventured into Nether at all, you know, let alone found the fortress and done all that stuff. But to be fair, I guess I am a little bit more protected, or actually kind of a lot more protected than I was last time. Like I was saying, when I got shot by the arrow last time, it only took like half a heart or something like that. So it was actually quite an impressive amount of kind of difference that it made. But really, regardless of all that, you know, the statement is still true. The Nether is just scary for me. There's just too many possibilities for danger, you know. If I get set on fire or anything like that, that could just completely wipe me out. But at the same time, it just can be so worthwhile, you know. What if I just run into a bastion and then I just find all the gold I could ever need? And really, at some point I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet and go in there, because there is just no way I can just not go in there and still beat the game. So I guess in that case I'll kind of put a few things back. I don't need any of you. Do I have any flint and more arrows I can make? There we go. How many can I make? Hey, that is plenty of arrows, thank you very much. You know, obviously we do have our milk pocket, so that's not really the worry for me at all in terms of getting poisons, or I don't even know, but just a fire is just so scary. Really, I reckon fire could just completely wipe all my hearts out in one fell swoop. But anyway, I guess we'll grab some blocks and whatnot. Oh, but actually before I do that, I am going to need to put on my gold. So I don't know if I have any enchanted gold, or do I just kind of put on my boots? Really, I remember I made two pairs of boots because I thought I was just going to be going through it like hell. But really, the armor shouldn't be taking damage, because that means I'm taking damage and I just can't afford that. So actually, I guess before I go in there, let's have a look if there was anything kind of, ooh, further falling might be nice. Maybe just kind of slap on protection 3 for, what is it, 10 levels? Really, honestly, that might be the thing that I just want. So I just wipe that on protection 3. Don't mind if I do, whatever. Let's try to avoid the hogs. No, hogs are already, oh my, son of a gun. At least you're only half a heart. I just forget how stupidly massive their entire hitbox is. It's just honestly ridiculous. And also, really, actually, first let me just go to try and get out of this hog hill right here, because oh my goodness, they are chasing me. Oh my goodness. Holy, this is not a good situation to be in. Let me just try and, ooh, can I climb a vine into safety? God, they really are just an absolute menace. My goodness, look at them all down there. Why are there so many right next to my portal? But all right, I reckon I'm just gonna kind of go in a little bit of an explore really quickly. Let's see if there's anything over here. Maybe we'll just kind of, you know, use, where is it? The efficiency 4? No, efficiency, okay, they're both efficiency 4. The unbreakable one will definitely be good for this. Here we go. I mean, I guess at the same time, I could also just use this iron pick. It is certainly fast enough. Ooh, here we go. Here's a little bit of kind of unprotected gold. Actually, considering it's kind of an ore drop, Fortune 3 should actually be quite helpful. Surely that actually gives me way more nugs. I mean, this certainly isn't a scientifically backed study or anything like that, but I feel as though in theory, whoa, yes. Oh my goodness, I haven't even thought about that. This actually might be kind of worth it now that I have Fortune 3. Alrighty then, well now I'm actually kind of excited to be in here, because it really is an entirely different ballgame where you actually can kind of make it a little bit more efficient and not just looking all around everywhere for nugs. I might actually have a whole bundle of gold very, very quickly. Ah, look at that, I already have over 2 stacks, oh my goodness. I mean, I guess also while I'm here, I might as well grab a little bit of this stuff. I certainly have to say, it's probably the most efficient, but still kind of a peaceful way to go about mining and getting experience. But here we go, okay, so I'll kind of mine around here, see if there's anything going to be down this tunnel over here. Sure, there's got to be a little bit more gold around. And you know, if I do have to kind of pop a golden apple while I'm here, that is no big deal. Really, I have no idea why I've just been letting my health kind of just dwindle down. I think I'm also thinking along the lines of, if I do need to use one, then it does actually give me additional effects. So maybe that's something that I will really need in that moment. And so, you know, I wouldn't dare want to waste one on just getting health back. Here we go. Here's a little bit more gold. How many is that? That is 4 stacks already. 2 stacks of that. Ooh, that's a pillar. Wow, I just nearly walked off my own pillar. I thought there was another rack under there. I reckon so far I'm doing all right in terms of losing health this round. Oh, whoa, here we go. Here's a little bit of a gold cave. You know, obviously we had a little bit of an incident when we first came through the portal, and I just got absolutely swamped by hogs. And I really don't know what the kind of best course of action is going to be to kind of deal with that every time I want to come in here. You know, talking about the hogs, they're just kind of a bunch of school bullies. They're just kind of waiting for me to go to lunch, and then they can just take my stuff. Because like I said, like you would have seen, you know, there were just so many of them that just crowd around the portal, and they're just absolutely gang up on me, and then they just run away when I actually want to hit them. It's just, oh, really, they have to be one of the most annoying enemies. I don't really know if I want to kind of trek it all the way up there, but then again, if I fall, I fall, and I will die, you know. There is no two ways about it. I mean, let's be honest, arrowing straight up certainly isn't an unsafe thing to do. I mean, is that, oh my goodness, eight almost stacks. I probably would have got 8 stacks of gold if I actually would venture down there and get it. I mean, obviously I've still got room in terms of I don't need any of the kind of netherrack or any kind of the quartz or whatnot, but oh my goodness, we are absolutely racking up all the gold. I honestly can't even believe how simple it now seems to kind of be doing this, but then again, at the same time, why would it ever be a kind of thing of this, you know? I'm just trying to avoid the nether at all costs. Well, I guess I wasn't until now. But really, now that I've realized my little kind of secret, so to say, there is going to be nothing stopping me. And really, I don't know if I'll ever actually kind of need to come back in here. We'll just have a little bit more of a look around here, see if there's anything just kind of around. Okay, you will be mad at me for doing that. So I guess I can kind of just make my way back down the stairs and then have a look. Hopefully you can't shoot me from there. There was more gold around though. I don't know where. Oh, there it is. There we go. Now the lava should be gone. But oh my goodness, I've just realized how much I've used my pick. Oh my goodness, I've been using the wrong one to kind of be mining. Okay. Alrighty then. So I guess we'll kind of head back up here, see if there's anything on our return journey that we want to get. Fairly certain there are plenty of other kind of avenues. Man, that they scared me. Whoa. Why are you so curious in me? I don't appreciate you just kind of coming in and checking me out. Now, I reckon with some quick maths right there, it'd be pretty safe to say that I have over 9 stacks of golden nugs. I mean, actually, look, I have a crafting table. I can just make some gold. No, not gold. Some gold. How many can we make? Oh my goodness. Over 1 stack of gold. Oh my god. All this time I've been just struggling and then finally just have 1 stack on hand. No worries. Wow, and then look at all that space I have now. That's incredible. Oh man, it just feels so liberating now that I just know I have all that gold. You know, I feel as though I could just kind of eat this golden apple right here, right now, and I just wouldn't even think twice about it. I'm still not going to, though. Maybe if I can ever find my way out of this place, I'll kind of celebrate by having one. You know, even the idea that I had last time I was in here with just kind of strip mining for things, it's just going to be so much easier considering the pickaxes I got. Not that I exactly feel as though I do want to go that down that path, or even that I need to now that I've got all this gold just at my disposal. There we go, finally level 30, you know. Actually, I reckon in honor of getting level 30, I reckon we will head home, you know. I will actually have to bring out the coordinates because I have no idea where I'm kind of venture to now. But I reckon with all this gold, we'll just quickly convert it all into ingots. And there we go. Look at that. 16 plus 64. So 80. Oh my god. 80. Which is actually perfect because that means I can get 10 more golden apples. Oh my goodness. Well, alrighty then. Well, I'm not actually that far. I'm gonna, here we go. I can probably even mine there, but I want to go which way? It goes way. Slow down, my man. I was just about to say that we might as well use the fast one, but you don't want to kind of be churning through potential. Here we go. It's not too far now. It's only another 100 blocks. And really, when I can kind of way. My goodness. I just don't know if I can actually use that one. Really, I reckon the speed of the efficiency 4 is just dangerous to be having. There's just no way you can control it, and you can really get yourself into a little bit of danger very quickly. Here we go. Now we've got oh my goodness, of course there is just a hole kind of waiting. Oh no, wait, don't tell me that they're waiting for me. Surely not. I guess first of all, I can kind of open up so I can try to see where I am, see if I can recognize where I am. I think, yeah, look at that. It certainly looks as though they're just finding the hole. They don't seem to be mad at me. I certainly wouldn't think that I have any reason to be mad at me considering, you know, I've been all the way over there. So yeah, the portal just must be down there. So I guess if nothing else, I'll just try and find a safe place to get down. Hello, I've just kind of been floating on a roof for the last however long. I reckon I'm just going to test the waters and just slowly creep out. Okay, good. Look at how many there are. I've almost had bodyguards right now. Look how fast that they can attack. How ridiculous is that? Like, really, I feel as though I had to time that perfectly to not be able to get hit there. But anyway, alrighty then. Let's kind of make a mad dash for it, shall we? Ooh, that's lava. Don't go in the lava. Here we go. Go. Hopefully there's not going to be a zombie thing. Ooh, here we go. Yes, we are finally home. Oh my goodness. This was certainly a successful endeavor trip. But look at that. Even since we actually kind of did all that, we have another 11 ingots. Wow. I feel as though I just have to put down a whole other chest just to be able to fill it up with netherrack and nether stuff. There we go. There it all is. And here we go. Where are our apples? Where are they? We've only got 2, but who cares? There we go. 2 more apples. Don't mind if I do. And then, you know, just another stack and a bit of a gold. Anyway, I reckon considering that was a very, very successful nether trip, you know, you just cannot argue with the amount of gold that I got. And thank you. Here we go. Look, a fortune 3 right there, which is an absolute godsend to get all this right here. And so yeah, you know, I guess so now that we've got all that gold, the main thing is just going to be apples. So I'm just gonna have to go over there and just do some apple farming. But anyway, in saying that, I reckon I'm gonna call it there. So thank you for watching. If you need to know this episode of Minecraft with No Regen, feel free to the YouTube and other things down below. Other than that, you know, if this is somehow your first episode and you're wondering what the hell's going on, there should be a player something now taking back to the beginning. Or maybe even just want to consider subscribing so I don't miss another one of these in the future. But all in all, have a good one and see ya.